you have the inverse Laplace transform of s+1 squared over s+4 to s+2 to the fourth. Okay. Again, a lot of people do partial fractions on this, and that will work, but it will take you a while, right? You have a over s+2, b over s+2 squared, c over s+2 cubed, d over s+2 to the fourth, and it's going to take you a long time. So what I do is I go, and the book, by the way, is just going to do partial fraction on all of these. I'm lazy, so I kind of get around it. Math, as I told you many times, mathematicians are inherently lazy. We try to make things as simple as possible. Here's what I would do. I would love that to be s+2, because then they would cancel, right? So what I would do is this. I would write this s+2 - 1, which might seem a little convoluted at first, but it's not. I still have s+1 here, right? I just wanted a +2, so I had to subtract a 1. What I would do from here then is multiply off the top, leaving the s+2 as it is, right? You don't want to distribute it because I'm back to where I was. So if I square that, what you would have is this. You'd have s+2 squared - 2s+2 + 1 over s+2 to the fourth. Okay? You probably see where I'm heading with this now. This allows me to break it up into three very simple fractions. You have 1 over s+2 squared minus 2 over s+2 cubed plus 1 over s+2 to the fourth. Okay? And now I can do all three of these at once. Again, I save myself a lot of work without doing the partial fractions. So I'm going to do a little differently. What I'm going to do right now, you do it in either order. You know that we had the shift, right? On all of them? All three of them. That's going to give me the e - -2t. Right? Pretty sure everyone does kind of ignore that and put that at the end. You also deal with that right away and then do the rest of it. It doesn't really matter because, you know, it's commuted. If you multiply, it doesn't matter which order you do it in. So you're going to have e - -2t. And then I can ignore that +2, right? The 1 over s squared, right? You can get rid of that 2. 1 over s squared is t. Right? Minus 2 over s cubed, right? The s cubed would have to have 2 factor, right? But that works out. We have 2 there already, so we're actually good to go there. So it's going to be minus t squared. And then this one, well, this one you have to do a little bit here, right? S to the fourth, well, you would need a 3 factorial up top. So you need to divide by a 3 factorial here. And of course, that's going to give you 1/6 t cubed. Okay? The 3 factorial is a 6, right? And the 3 factorial of that comes into that. And that's what you end up with.
If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.